It's not a lie. If you would just listen, I could explain.
You have done quite enough explaining, Volothamp Gadam. You have poisoned the very hearts and minds of these good, kind, gentle citizens with your lies, your delusions, your conspiracies. Though you hide behind a mask of stories, we have seen beyond the veil. We see what you really are. Fearmonger.
Hear, hear!
Attention seeker.
Hear, hear!
Agent of chaos.
Your parasite stirs in recognition. This man is infected.
Ragnahel's follow!
Today, citizens, we rid ourselves of this cankerous sore. Today, we burn away all falsehoods. Today, we will be divided no longer, for today, we rise in truth!
Psst. Don't just stand there! Help me, goddammit! Help me!
We're not gonna let this happen, are we? Volo's... well, he's Volo.
What's this? Another heretic in our midst? Another mind clouded by the disruptor's lies? Another soul to cleanse? Well, we are nothing if not gracious. Let us see if we cannot lift the veil from their eyes too.
No! Please! No!
Jimmy on the go.
By my hand.
Need to act fast. Focus straight through. Oh.
Position.
up to focus. Time to deal some punishment. Onward. Not no failure.
Trust me.
Gods. I really thought I was done for. I suppose thanks are in order. Again, what's an heroic story without a little risking of one's neck, eh?
And you know what they say, the bigger the story,
the more people want to kill you for it.
I'll tell you all about it. But not here.
Too many eyes, ears, and wear palms about. Meet me at your camp.
You'll have to wash them all. Marek will never let you come back.
Children, you can't look at the family.
Oh, Wave Mother, Queen of the Depths, hear me. Please carry Holly to her final rest in the deep wilds. Please. Sorry, are you here for a Wave Servant Holly's funeral? Oh, it's already started. They're just inside. no. All are welcome to come and celebrate the life of the fallen wave servant. May the Wave Mother smile on you as she did Holly.
Floric, former advisor to Duke Ravengard, has been found guilty of treacherous and seditious activity against the people of Baldur's Gate. She will be executed 5 days hence.
Of course they do.
I brought my own paring knife. Now I just need some ingredients, and I'm gonna make something really good, I promise.
It is splendid to see you again, my friend. If you hadn't saved me from that mob, I'd be penning a guide to the afterlife based on first-hand experience. Perhaps you would hazard a guess as to why the mob turned on me? pish-posh. That strutting tyrant has a long reach and a steel fist, but he's a puppy dog compared to the real horror that haunts our streets. The Lord of Murder has returned. As he did 100 years ago, Baal has set his accursed sights on Baldur's Gate. And his temple runs red with the blood of the innocent. Orin is his chosen. And like Saravok before her, she is able to take on the savage form of the Slayer. If the Slayer is not stopped, it will slaughter every living thing in this city. As one of those things, I'm particularly eager to stop it. And there is a way. I have a study of the beast, penned by the wizard Irenicus himself. It contains all the knowledge needed to slay the Slayer. Now I just need a brave adventurer, willing to face Baal's chosen, and to put the knowledge into practice. Wonderful! I can scarcely think of anyone more suitable. It will serve you well. A study of the Slayer penned by John Irenicus. It's one of a kind, so do try to keep it away from the inevitable bloodbath, hmm? The Dream Eater. It is said the children of Baal are claimed throughout their sleep, ever disturbed by visions of a life of bloodshed and terror. Once they have seen too much, once these dreams drive their minds to break, they are beset by the Slayer. It is a beast of unspeakable violence that consumes all in its path, including the soul of the one who is host to it. A genius. Exiled from his home in the elven paradise of Soldanessala, when he attempted to seize the power of life itself, he instead turned his magnificent mind to murder on a grand scale. That is how he came to crave the power of the Baal spawn. He saw them not as living things, but as tools for his own machinations. In the end, though Irenicus took the form of the Slayer for himself, it was a Baal spawn who thwarted him, the same that saved Baldur's Gate. Quite so. I was rather hoping you'd gathered all the rest of the adventuring paraphernalia yourself. You'll need every advantage. I am a living witness to Baal's defeat those 100 years ago. So I know your battle against him is not futile. He can be stopped. But not all of those who stood against him survived. And those who did were never the same again. I wish you luck, my friend. And I hope that when I see you again, you'll be in one piece. Two or three at most.
I brought my own paring knife.
Tadpole quivers, revealing your discussion with Mizora to Will.
Shit. Father's been taken, and Mizora started to scheme. By all the hounds of the Hells, what is she planning? Certainly not. But she's as inevitable as Toril's path around the sun. We'll have answers soon enough. Let's talk to Mizora. Until then, may my father keep safe, whatever coop he's been flown to.
What's next, I wonder?
Attention! Eat it.
Wait to sleep.
That's a good idea, Geoff.
asking the impossible. Gyrenetics require a steady hand and a sharp gaze. I can barely keep my eyes open. I need to rest.
You have a son, do you not? Is he as lazy and pathetic as his spineless mother?
Wait! Stay your hand, I beg you.
Prinsky's motivation sequence activated.
Tell me, Gondian. Tell me about your son.
He's not... Yes, Overseer Holt. He's frail in body and mind like me, like all of us. Yet by your grace, he lives.
And your wife?
She is... was useless and interfered with production quotas. You were wise to remove her from this world. Forgive my outburst. I will work through the night. This watcher will be operational by dawn.
I will allow it. But if your work is anything short of impeccable, your son will die screaming. Is that clear?
Yes. Overseer Holtz.
Red Brother, stand ready. Gondians, so much as twitch, and I'll rip your tongues out myself.
You recognize the Overseer's uniform. She's a follower of Bane, the god of tyranny.
Interloper, how did you get in here? It matters not. You revealed yourself for nothing. The Gondians wouldn't know a spine if I ripped it from their backs and beat them with it. Gondians, cut out the interloper's eyes.
Overseer, please. We're engineers, not killers.
What happens to the disobedient, slave?
I will do it, Overseer.
True.
explosion, the earth shuddering beneath your feet in response.
About to hammer right out of my chest. Thank you.
stay idle.
I didn't want to attack you. None of us did. Well, this is a disaster. They're dead. They're all dead. No. You don't understand. The Overseers hold more than our lives hostage. They have our families. And if they see what we've done, killing me will only be the beginning. God help us.
Bodies.
I have to hide this. I could cut them up.
Or Masters,
perhaps hit them.
Heading out.
Swift and lethal. Make way. Got to keep fighting. Got to move. Taking position.
sometimes the only way out is through.
I'll fit in there.
Goofgrish of the lore. Your nervous gait betrays your presence, stranger. You don't belong here. Who are you? Blackaith! Why? Your presence imperils us all. If any of us attempts to escape, our kin will die. The Overseers. They have a contraption. When triggered, it will kill everyone who wears a collar. You underestimate the enemy. The Overseers, they are Glixbrand Rakthar. The collars are not only equipped with explosives. There is also a mechanism that alerts the Overseers if they're removed. One of us may be able to save themselves, but it would be at the expense of everyone else. We can't risk it. Even if we did somehow unshackle our collars simultaneously and overthrow our oppressors, there would be consequences. Our families are held elsewhere. The Overseers need only activate those contraptions they hold, and they suffer the consequences of our actions too. We cannot win. We must aid in building these Vakon. Gun-gull. Aye. Even more, I'd help you destroy this place. I don't know where they are, but some of the Overseers must. You'll have to infiltrate deeper into the foundry. Just make sure you don't get caught. If they raise the alarm, they'll trigger the collars. I will pray for you. My daughter, her name is Obinia, Gondra Thrakas Hulnish. May Gond be with you. Patience, it hasn't been long.
sisters, be my testament. Notum sit in Beator.
Notum sit in Beator.
Holy hells.
I come to bargain. The Hells demand witness.
Your parasite links with Will's, and your memories flow into him. He sees his father's flight from Worm's Rock, and hears Mizora's words to you.
Shit! Where did Gortash send my father? How do I save him?
Sisters.
Infernos contractus te vocamus. Infernos contractus te vocamus. Infernos contractus te vocamus.
Your contract, Will. Signed in blood, forged in fire, bound in bone, but not unbreakable. A life for a life. No contract is ended without sacrifice. The cost must be paid. Will Ravenguard, a choice is before you. Option one. I show you the way to your father. I guarantee him no harm except that from you and your allies. And you pledge your soul to me and the Archdevil Zariel in a pact eternal. Option two. I break your pact and you are freed from your duty. Your father dies by his enemy's hand, and Baldur's Gate loses its greatest champion. Name your sacrifice.
Bloody Zariel. I won't let her take Will.
Silence, Karlach.
Mizora, you asshole!
Choose. Addendum F. The Absolute must be avenged for the Soulbinder's detention at Moonrise. The Soulbearer retains his gifts until such time as the Absolute is slain.
You damned wretch!
Father.
Do it. Break the pact.
Fiat ita.
Fiat ita. Anima ad beator.
Didn't think you had it in you. Seems my boy's all grown up. And don't go fussing about your father. You made your choice. You knew the terms. You know what? I think I'll stick around. Not for the greater good, you understand. Just for the entertainment.
How did you? Oh, it's you. I must have let my mind wander. Enough for you to wander in. Forgive me. I am drained. Ever since you killed Ketherick and took his Netherstone, the Chosen's control of the brain has been brittle. It's rebelling against Orin and Gortash, fiercely. I suspected that when we took Ketherick's stone, the brain would begin to break free. Those brain quakes confirm that my suspicion was correct. I do not know what happens now when it receives their orders, and I do not dare guess.
You feel the Emperor's fear as if it were your own. An Elder Brain enslaved is one thing. An Elder Brain unleashed will be the end of everything.
Beautiful, isn't it? The mighty Prince Orpheus, contained in submissive slumber. Come. You may as well sit a while, now that you are here. Your company isn't unwelcome. An accurate summary. I have found myself distracted of late. I'm haunted by memories. They are relentless. I can think of nothing. No one else. Duke Stelmane, or Belin, as I knew her. I wasn't ready for her death. You thought you were my first ally. Far from it. I have long sought the allyship of others. It is the only way to succeed. Though my relationship with Belin was different from my relationship with you. In a way, but not the way you're thinking of. In life, she was my business partner. Back when we ran the Knights of the Shield. A difficult task for a mind flayer. Duke Stelmane trusted me, and the city trusted her. I conceived the plot, but Belin took center stage. It was she who met with the merchants, politicians, and patriarchs. It was she who negotiated deals and signed off on agreements. Her rooms played host to the most important conversations in the city. Together, we brought order to chaos. At its height, everything that happened in that city went through the shield, through us. I could not have done any of it without her. Just as I cannot do any of this without you. But now, she is gone. I appreciate your understanding. What I feel is deeper than superficial cures can reach. and not entirely unwelcome. Most people think that Mind Flayers are soulless husks who feel nothing. I am glad you are not most people. Another quake. The brain is rebelling again. I need to focus. And so do you.
Bastards deserved it.
Show him who you are. Victory awaits. You bow or you break. Give up. Bleed.
bleed for me.
Knees high.
Victory awaits. My time. Take you.
Deactivated. Thank the gods.
Healing.
Guards are watching me. Take you first.
tactical. Say bye-bye.
Victory awaits. Make way.
Terrifying once you've done it before.
Got to move.
Got it.
Time to strike.
still breathing, despite everything.
Victory awaits. Taking position.
I won't give in. Think you can take me on.
Prinsky's motivation sequence activated.
Done. Nothing to it.
Ooh, fun.
The watcher this brain controls is offline for maintenance. The brain dreams, images of life in a garden cottage in spring.
Taste my fury!
Ready for another round? Watch this!
Survival is all that matters. No time for mercy.
The hammer's gonna fall.
Thank you.
injuries need tending. On the move. No failure.
Let's kick in.
No time to rest.
My faith will guide me.
You will not take me.
Take your...
Still alive, so that's progress.
Aye.
Blood comes easy these days. These boots have seen everything.
Heading there.
Victory awaits. On the move. What should I do?
Activated. Thank the gods.
Still on my feet.
Need to act fast. Onward.
The inscription reads, "Fresh supplies for the Steel Watch, courtesy of Necromancer Balthazar."
out of your court.
No, there is no other way.
It's been a long day. Better stop to rest soon.
Queen Vlakith. Skvar!
You are Hshalak! And still you speak my name.
I've seen the captive Orpheus with my own eyes. Spoken to Shestil Kithrak Vos. You lied to us. Enslaved us.
The betrayer Vos lies! I have only a moment, and you, Hshalak, will listen. We are Githyanki. We move mountains. We snuff out stars. We shake the plains! The traitor Vos has lied to you. The heretic prince would shatter us in an instant. The great dominion shrunk to the head of a pin.
Can this be true? Is the Githyanki prince really a threat to his own people? Or simply a challenge to Vlakith's rule?
Return to the Astral Prism! Slay Orpheus the Pretender! Serve me, and I will ascend you. You will be no mere warrior, nor Kithrak. You will be Barter Vlakith, Commander of Dragons. My only, my chosen. A final chance. Kneel before me. Make your promise.
Lazar's thoughts become yours. The sight of Orpheus looms over her mind. Vos's words echo within it. She means to forever turn her back on Vlakith.
Called me traitor. I gave you my life, and you ordered your knights to hunt me. I have witnessed too much, and you have given me too little. Finally, I can see. Orpheus will live, and I will hear his creed. This is my word.
Your word is nothing! You are nothing! The Kithraki will bring you. I will tear your flesh from your bones and devour your skull's marrow while you beg for death. I will consume you. I will unmake you.
It is done. There is no going back.
As long as the Undying Queen reigns, I am never to soar unbound over the Astral Sea. Never to cross the One in the Void. As it should be. Better a short life built on truth than immortality woven of lies. Better to unite the Githyanki under a prince who would free their minds and honor their bodies. So why do I feel so bitter?
Lazel has been ostracized by her queen. Why should she not feel bitter?
To molten rock, forever rattling in the belly. But I've never known this. I feel no heat, no cold. I bear neither fangs nor talon. There is only absence. No matter. I am Vlakith's child no more. I have been born anew in Gith's son, my savior. And so, from the old battle cries is birthed another. Tmar Salar Orpheus, must still now forgen in Yeri. Orpheus's will above all. May the comet blaze my path forward. We take the Orphic hammer from Raphael's lair. Orpheus Tavki Nazin. Vos has done his duty. Now, we will do ours. We must find our way to the House of Hope and take the Orphic hammer. When we next enter the Astral Prism, we will use the hammer to break Orpheus free.
Gods. I spent 7 years choked by Mazura's leash. And I spent 7 years hoping to break free. I never knew freedom could taste so bittersweet. I have to believe that. I'm not the Hell's puppet in life, nor its warrior in death. The Blade will be guiding his own hand. But freedom will be paid in my father's blood. Tomorrow, I celebrate my gain. Today, I mourn my loss.
A moment passes. In the stillness, you find a mote of tranquility.
The Raven Guard name now lives solely with me. I will make it count for something. I signed his life away before the Hell's Witnesses. It would be easier to drink the Styx down to the last drop than to alter his fate. I'd be a fool to wish otherwise. We obtain the final two Netherstones and take back our minds and the city from the Brain.
I still feel the Shadowfell all over me. Still hear her words in my ear. I feel unclean. You've nothing to be sorry for. Far from it, in fact. Without your help, things could have ended very differently for me. I have an idea. Something I've wanted to do for a while. Something that might help me put her in the past. But I'll need your help. Wait until the others are asleep, then come with me. There's a place we can go, down the coast a little. This will do. Take off your clothes. Well, you can't be of much help to me from the shoreline, can you? Shouting moral support while I drown. Come on, then. We've already come this far. Fine. Well, don't just stand there. Turn around. You haven't even attempted to peek. I'm a little offended. That's one word for it, I suppose. You can turn around again. What? Don't just stare. I know. Your turn. I can do this, now that I'm here. All right, just stay close. To know I can face things without Shah. I don't want to go back. Not just yet. Just a pebble. Now don't you dare stop.
Moment.
Got to press on.
Nothing important is ever easy.
Thank you. life full color.
Get a little kiss.
Halt, citizen. Submit to inspection. In the name of Lord Enver Gortash.
The parasite reels in your skull. Something within the Steel Watcher tugs at your mind.
Your trial is complete, villain. And the sentence is imprisonment. Please comply.
Close ranks.
Been easy for Lazelle to stand up to Vlakith like that. But there's nothing that woman can't do.
Better than nothing.
God's damn disease of the gate. Lady Mazora told me everything. How you and the Blade of Frontiers slaughtered his own father. How he craves ultimate power. How he means to make the city bow to him and him alone. First I finish you, then I finish the Duke's traitorous son! I believe you. The Battle Lord helped me. What darkness has fallen upon us? Listen, there's something Will should know. On his way from Elturel, Ravengard sent a messenger with word of the cult. He knew about the Absolute. I thought little of it at first, but he realized the danger before anyone else did. He understood that if the cult was successful in raising an army, Baldur's Gate would be doomed. And he knew that to protect the city, one trained in the ways of the great champions would have to rouse the worm living beneath. If I'm not mistaken, that would be Will. A bronze dragon, to be precise, sleeping beneath us. The worm goes by many names. Ansel, the Waiting Storm, the Heart of the Gate. He made Baldurin a binding promise to protect the city when its need was greatest. The city survived countless threats, but Ravengard knew its walls would fall to the cult. With him gone, and the city near ruin, your call is to unleash the Heart of the Gate. Take this. The Legend of Ansel. The bards call it a tall tale, but every last word is true. Follow its path to the worm, or do not, and let the coast be drowned in blood. I was right to lay down my arms. Fauxhammer be praised. I should go, gather allies. We'll join you in your hour of need. Free the worm, and may his thunderous wind drive the Absolute from the coast.
The mouth says.
Halt, villain. In the name of Lord Enver Gortash.
This is your end.
Yeah! Intende.
Down the hatch.
No time to waste.
Can't give up. Have to keep going.
I'm heating up. Over there.
Forward.
poor fucker.
Time to strike.
I brought my own paring knife.